balloon, floating, mesmerizing. We go to the phones. Yes, we do.
I can't believe you actually recommended we go to Barbados on our honeymoon. It was revolting. There were poor people. I live in Vinewood to be away from poor people.
Barbados is lovely.
Look, I want to be very clear. I'm not racist. Just careful.
Okay.
I like all-inclusive resorts where you can drink as much as you want, be around other people from San Andreas, and the only interaction you have with the locals is if you need a cocktail or some spice in the bedroom with your husband.
Well, that sounds lovely. With people like you, it's no wonder we don't bother curing cancer. Next caller, you're on the Wild Traveler.
Yeah, it's funny. You go on and on about other countries, but you live here. America rules you, commie. Eat me.
Well, we've been trying. Tom, you're on the line.
I'm so sick of England. Oh, let's go to the pub. They're all alcoholics. At least we drink a 24-pack in private instead of hanging out in some social setting making a fool of ourselves. People say it's so civilized in Europe. They got thousands of years of history. Well, I saw a movie about Europe once and I was disgusted. I mean, people still defecate in their living rooms and cover it up with dirt like a cat. You can't find a decent toilet anywhere. Or a good chicken wing. And the strippers? Overcharge.
Good Lord, you're Philistine. You should stay out of England. I hear there is a casino in Venturas that is just like the rest of the world, only with better toilets and full of morons like you. Do you want culture or do you want safety? It's your choice. Personally, I want irrigation of the colonic variety. But that's a whole different story, and it is early. Let's go to the phones. Who's on the phones? No one? Come on, call up. Anyone? It wouldn't be like this in Peru, I can tell you. There I once made a phone call with 30 boys sitting on my lap. Not because I paid them. They wanted to be there. Or in Mali, where nobody knows what a phone is, and a lot of people have never even heard of plastic surgery, or the Glory Hole theme park. There, the Glory Holes aren't theme parks, I can tell you. It's violent and bloody and authentic. What are you scared of? You wimps! Give me a call! Someone! Please! Hello, you're on Wild Traveler. Where are you?
I'm on a cliff.
How romantic.
I want to jump.
I know what you mean. Jump into the unknown. How can it be a sin if it feels good? Anyway, what's your question?
Why am I here?
I don't know. Why are you there? Where are you? Kenya?
No, I'm in Verde Bluffs.
Loathsome place. I'd jump if I were you.
I want to go to hell.
Me too. Buy a refrigerator magnet when you get there. On with the show. Any callers? No? Okay, maybe I should hit the travelogue again. This is from my diary in Sri Lanka. For a few rupees a day, I have employed the services of a young man who has been my guide in pleasure as well as travel. There is something very exotic about him, Avrinda. He could be a boy, but like many locals, in certain lights, he looks just like a little girl. He is a real minx who knows exactly what he is doing to me. Oh, wrong page. Here we are. Avrinda took me deep into jungle, and there we took part in an ancient rite of passage for adolescents on the cusp of adulthood. We hunted each other in game, very similar to the ancient games of...
Get out of my way, I'm a cop!
South again. On the next show, we'll be discussing Amsterdam, Paradise Regained, Morocco, spooky smoke. Until next time, travel safe. Ciao, Bella. I'm James Bediston, and this has been The Wild Traveler.
This is WCTR, committed to bringing you shows like The Wild Traveler, even if we received a cease and desist.
Deal with your ignorance in 1 minute flat. Complex issues in 60 seconds. WCTR.
Tired of all the sunshine and good weather? Looking for a real American vacation? Visit the Shining Jewel in the Rust Belt Crown. Carcer City. It's a real man's vacation. The pride of a nation is in Carcer City. It's steel, ice, and poverty. Spend a romantic evening in the beauty of the nighttime river glow at the Flaming River. Watch real men who make things lose their jobs and fight on our special Closing the Mill guided tour. Come see what we're really made of. This is real America. Drunk, proud, unemployed, and angry. Hear the eagle roar in Carcer City. This is what the Heartland is all about.
And now, the number one show for vegetables on the radio, Gardening with Maurice.
Okay, we are back in the garden. I'm Maurice, and we must answer nature's call. Going to the phones. Greetings, garden lover. What's your name?
Hi, my name's Trish.
Okay, is that short for Patricia?
Yeah.
Oh, then what I asked is what your name was, not the nickname your skinhead boot-wearing friends call you at the rallies. Maybe you should do less drugs and learn to try a bit harder. Next caller!
Hi, my name is Colleen, and my husband has a topiary problem.
Ooh, this sounds serious.
Well, he started off small scale, just recreational usage. You know, doing horses and cockerels, the odd unicorn. But it's kind of gotten out of control.
How so?
He just can't stop. I mean, people think it's all fun and games. But what happens when the party stops? What happens then?
Okay, just hold the phone. Hold the phone and get a grip, okay? At my house, when the party stops, we pay the gimp, get rid of the sailors, and 15 men start crying in unison.
Well, that's your business. My husband's reached bottom. It's terrible. Giraffes, lions, elephants, rhinos, all of them carved out of hedges. Penguins, dogs, velociraptors, you name it, he's made a leafy version.
What could be more natural than a man trimming a hedge into the shape of an animal? Very therapeutic. Makes a man feel like a god. When you can twist nature to your own perverse entertainment, then you know we've won. Eat me, Darwin.
But now he's trimming bushes into a spaceship, a rocket, and a lance. He runs around with hedge clippers and screams, "Trim that bush! Hit our neighbors!" He even fashioned a shrub into a kangaroo with a pouch, and he sleeps inside it some nights. Oh, he's freaking out on Bush. He needs help. Please, you gotta help me. I hate hedges.
Well, the Romans loved topiary, and look at their contributions to society. But as they say, if the grass is greener in the other fella's yard, then you bang his college son when the dad's out of town. Okay, next caller. Whoops, hold on a second, I'm blossoming. Are you blossoming?
I guess I am. I've really come into my own in the past few months since I joined a cult and began tithing money in exchange for spiritual happiness and letting everyone take turns on my wife. Anyway, I have a lovely garden, mostly carnivorous plants. A Venus flytrap reminds me of my mother. She's in prison now. Anyway, it's so fascinating how it catches animals and eats them. I started with flies, and now mine can swallow a whole squirrel. Or a small horse if I chop it in half first.
Have you tried any experiments on human beings?
Yeah, I've been working on that.
Good man! Good man! See, the secret of nature is once something is at the height of beauty and potential, it is time for it to wither and die. A bit like the British Empire. Look at that whole place withering and dying right before our eyes. It's run by a queen, and if she had a pistol, she'd be the king. Luckily, in this country, we don't know the meaning of the word hubris. But hell, I'm all over the place here. It's so easy to get out of control when you're doing something that comes natural. Line two, you're on Gardening with Maurice.
Yeah, my name is Terrence.
Can I call you Telly Welling?
Sure, I guess. I'm growing flowers, but sometimes I get really angry, fly off the handle, commit herbicides. I don't mean to. I say, "I didn't mean it, baby. You'll be all right." Then I cry and wear a diaper for 2 days.
A flower is nothing more than an educated weed. And like all weeds, all living things need to be extinguished! Like a life support machine or a cigarette, which I won't be able to smoke anymore if the fascists and the state government have anything to say about it with that damn proposition. God, I pray to the great gardener in the sky that you've been fixed. I hope they sniffed your nuts off, because spreading your seed could be a disaster. Do you have a question? A question? God, so many vegetables on this show. Tards.
Yeah, that guy was talking about bugs and plants that eat them.
I got a better solution. Player.
Put pesticide in the sprinklers. My kids love it. I mean, the ones that live.
Oh, lovely. You're a lovely human being. Fucking insult. You morons in this town are spreading like weed. A real man loves enormous trees that he can have his way with, chopping them down and using the wood to fashion rocking horses and suggestive whirligigs. Okay, we're running out of time, literally. But again, like a seed sown in a hurricane or a mushroom spore from outer space, the garden goes on. I'm Maurice. Until next time, dig a hole and plant yourself.
That was the show that generates more phone calls than any other on WCTR, Gardening with Maurice.
The day of liberation is here. Throughout history, only the biggest and strongest survive. Being big means you're successful, and women love big men.
Kilimanjaro.
And as a successful man, you need to feel comfortable when you're sitting down to eat.
Kilimanjaro.
Clothes for the bigger man. Don't be bound by society, bogus medicine, and the media with their unhealthy focus on being skinny. Don't be constrained by trying to squeeze into a triple X. Bored of feeling like a man in a sausage skin in your size 48 jeans? Bored of being uncomfortable?
Kilimanjaro,
the clothes shop for enormous men. We're fighting to end hunger. Yours.
Kilimanjaro.
The most boring show with a brand new host. Entertaining America with Laszlo.
Welcome to Entertaining America on WCTR with me, Laszlo. So, the media, you may hate us, but I gotta tell you, we hate ourselves more. And stop accusing us of being liberal. What a load of crap. This station is owned by Ammunation. I mean, have you ever heard anyone complain about guns on this station? Hosts are getting shot by them all the time, but it just gets glossed over. But it also means I now have a job. If you're afraid of your mortality and never want to die, here's the solution. It's a man who's got all of America talking with his unique approach to spiritual matters. He's helped thousands, or so the press pack tells me. Chris Formage, founder of the Epsilon program, is here. Hello, Chris.
Kiflam, brother, brother.
What does that mean, man? So, Epsilonism, is it a load of crap, or is it the future?
Well, what do you think, Laszlo?
I don't know. Well, I mean, I grow my own religion. That's just why I don't know, as I'm kind of spaced out. I mean, but you guys run around chanting lip balm.
It's Kiflam.
Well, whatever. Both sound addictive to me. You know, only popular people are addicted to either. Let's go to the phones.
Hey, Chris, Epsilon sounds awesome. But if you read the fossil records, hunter-gatherer dudes had it made. I mean, who wouldn't want to drag their women around by their hair? They smoked anything they could find. That's, like, so freaking cool. Then all the men would, like, disappear for days at a time, and you'd only hear beasts shrieking in the distance.
You know, I went to a museum once. That guy's got a point.
Points are irrelevant, Laszlo. Let me ask you something. Do you want to be happy, Laszlo?
What kind of question is that? Yes, obviously.
Then why?